Alola! Welcome to Alola!
Isn't it kind of redundant?
Well, originally I was going to say Aloha, welcome to Alola.
But in game they're like, when you greet someone, you say Alola. And I see someone on Twitter say, that's like saying America to somebody as a greeting.
Yeah, it kind of is.
America, welcome to America. Or Australia, welcome to Australia.
Well, at the moment, at the rate to take a stab at politics for a little bit, it could be, hey, America, welcome to Trump, well, to Trump country.
Trump land.
Oh, God damn it. We were right all along. He is Dr. Eggman.
Oh, no. It's Eggman land.
Yeah, just Wayne, if he starts working on a giant amusement park, he's Eggman.
Gumshoes aside, let's talk about Sun and Moon.
Wait, which gumshoes? I thought is he finally getting a pay rise to buy more than just instant noodles?
Wait, what? Why are we talking about Final Fantasy all of a sudden? I just heard something about cup noodles.
Oh, Detective Gumshoes. We could go a lot of places with just this continuing thread. All from this one Pokemon.
Yeah, it's either Trump or Gumshoes from
Ace Attorney.
But let's talk about Sun Moon.
Indeed. We're finally getting to it. It took us a little while to get here because of family issues and all that, but yeah. Welcome to the first review of the new year that we're recording at the end of last year.
Pokemon Sun and Moon time.
Yay!
So are we talking about stories, spoilers and all, or no?
Yeah, the game has been out for over a month now, so this is going to be spoiler heavy. But, right. Well, just pointing that out there now, it may end up not being, but as a just in case.
Yeah. So in the story, you get to do this and this and that. That's just so much spoilers, but...
Indeed. One thing that some consider a spoiler that I don't because it's in the first cutscene. Yes, yeah. Aether Foundation are bad guys.
Well, yeah, would they be considered a crime syndicate, I guess?
Not a crime syndicate, and to be fair, calling them the bad guys is a very easy definition that doesn't really work for them, because after the story itself, a lot of them go back to what they were doing before, which was helping Pokemon.
When I see the Aether Foundation, like, part of it is corrupted when you go real deep into it, but the majority of it, like, I guess the employees that don't know any better what's going on the inside, they're just doing their jobs, like helping Pokemon, whatever.
Yeah, exactly.
It's very corrupted, and, like, a corrupted little thing. And then Team Skull, aka my new favorite team since Aqua.
Yo.
Oh, it's so good. I love Team Skull.
I'll give props to Team Skull because they've done the one thing that no evil team has done before, and the one thing that has put them far above any other evil team to me. The one thing I thought was despicable, cruel, evil beyond all imagining.
What?
They made me pay to use a Pokemon Center.
Oh, how cruel.
No!
It was like, that was 10 Poké from my wallet, straight into their pockets.
And then I had to pay 10,000 Poké Dollars for a t-shirt. What?
Well, that's paying good money for a good t-shirt. I would give them that. But paying for a Pokemon Center? Come on.
I don't know, this is Team Skull we're talking about, so who knows, this could be secondhand. You don't know where it's been.
You know what's interesting about Team Skull? They have to find their own outfits.
Yeah.
And another interesting thing about Team Skull, there was another team named Team Skull. Do you remember where?
Yes, I do. I'm just trying to, how do their theme go, or... get off the top of my head.
I'll get the theme for you.
Yeah, the Team Skull theme isn't one I remember from Explorers series. mainly because it kind of loses to Wigglytuff's theme and Team Charm's theme.
Right. Oh, I remember the Team Skull theme. It had a lot of rapping, right? I type in Team Skull theme and all I get is Sun and Moon stuff.
Wrong one!
Wrong Team Skull. Here we go. Here's the Team Skull theme. If you want it.
Gotta love it sometimes.
Somebody needs to do a mashup of Team Skull and Team Skull.
I'll save it for post-production.
Alright.
It will go in 3, 2, 1, now.
Follow along with the music. The music will help you get a feel for how fast to push. Let the chest rise all the way back up after each push. If you stay directly over the chest and keep your arm straight, it's a lot easier.
Now this is a story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became the prince of a town called Bel-Air. In West Philadelphia, born and raised on the playground is where I spend most of my days. Chilling out, maxing, relaxing, all cool and all, shooting some b-ball outside of the school. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started making trouble in my neighborhood. I got in one little fight and my mom got scared and said, you're moving with your auntie and uncle in Bel-Air. Day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on and said I might as well kick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking orange juice out of a champagne glass.
I have a theory about Team Skull. So
at the... What was that? You dropped out.
That's okay. I have a theory for Team Skull.
And that is?
At the end of the game, post-game, you meet Team Skull Grunts again, but they'd say, we're not big battle Team Skull anymore. We want to do our part and help rescue Pokemon. Yeah, we'll be called Team Re-Skull. My theory is, if the theory that the Mystery Dungeon universe is after the human universe is true, like, it's actually in a jump of time, not in a jump in the universe.
Yep.
The Explorers Team Skull are probably descendants of the Alolan Team Skulls.
It's Guzma's great... Well, Skuntank is Guzma's great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandson.
Great. Yeah. Well, I mean, look at their hair.
Why didn't Guzma have a skun tank? Why?
Because he was actually mainly bug. I'm wondering why didn't I mean the what was her name?
Plumeria.
Plumeria. Why didn't Plumeria have a skun tank? Wait, did she?
No, yes. But she did have Salazzle, which I'm gonna save Salazzle for when we get to the Pokédex.
Yeah, that's an interesting Pokemon.
Yeah, and you mind if we go to the Pokedex now and get back to the story?
Well, let's finish the story first before we get on with the Pokemon.
Alright.
So, Sun and Moon.
Oh. The best way to describe the story, though, overall, parental abuse.
Yes, heavy parental abuse.
Yeah, and...
Well, not parental abuse, child abuse.
Well, parental abuse in terms of Guzma and his family, child abuse for Lusamine and Lily.
Right.
And Gideon.
Poor Lily.
Yeah. Though, one thing I will admit for Lily, which I think was a bit of a disappointment that I hope is coming in for Stars, which at time of recording is still a rumor, for the record, We should have had a battle with her.
Yeah.
Post-game battle, we should have had a battle with her.
Well, the thing is, she was never a Pokemon trainer, and then she went to Kanto. She went to Kanto, I'm not sure whether to become one or just to help her mom.
I think it was a bit of both.
Yeah. I would love to see, like, if she does return for Battle Tree. I always wondered, would Professor Oak give her a starter Pokemon? And I always imagined she would get picked Bulbasaur.
Probably. Though, just hope that she doesn't Mega Evolve it, because, again, going back to that Pokedex, who wrote the thing this time?
Well, if you have a ghost type in your Pokedex, you kind of expect to see some weird stuff.
Yeah, but the Pokedex has gone from creepy to depressing.
Rotom, are you okay in there?
You're making me feel bad because I gave Kangaskhan a stone, and now I've potentially broken up a family. I'm a monster!
How could you do this? Wait, what do you mean give Kangaskhan a stone?
According to the Alolan Pokedex, when you Mega Evolve Kangaskhan, because all of its energy goes into the child becomes a lot more aggressive. So the mother thinks that she's ruined her child. So,
But the child is... Wait. Moon. Thanks to Mega Evolution, its child grows, but as the child is good at only fighting, nothing else, its mother feels uneasy about its future.
Yeah.
But then Sun is more cheerful, that says Mega Kangaskhan's strength derives from the mother's happiness about her child's growth. Watching it grow up keeps her spirits high. Moon is depressing, and Sun is good.
Oh no, Sun's got some depressing moments too. But most of it is in Moon.
Why is Moon so depressing?
I don't know. The other one kind of makes the episode in the XY series make sense. We learn why Lucario becomes so aggressive when it Mega Evolves. It becomes violent overly violent, and Salamence has been known to kill its own trainer when it Mega Evolves.
I did.
Your favorite!
Thank you! I'm probably dead now because I have. Go, Mega Salamence! Ah! But then again, Beware is confirmed to kill trainers.
Ugh. Well, we knew that one was coming. But I'm almost afraid to learn of what Blaziken and Gardevoir's ones are when the bank opens. Because you can't get either of them yet.
I'm still very curious about Rotom. Because. Rotom doesn't have a Pokedex entry, and there's a Rotom in my Pokedex, and yet it's not in the Alolan Dex.
Logic. Also, Rotom, you scare me. Stop that.
I like Rotom in the Pokedex. I was actually watching a Nuzlocke of Moon, and when they got the Rotom for the Pokedex, and he just blinks on the bottom screen, they're like, ew, it's like a Furby.
Kind of is.
I like how he talks, though. Yeah.
He wasn't creepy before when he could turn to things like a lawnmower, a washing machine, a fridge, an oven, a fan.
And now he's in your Pokedex.
Wait, what the... I think I found out a way of making the thing Rotom even scarier.
How?
If the fan that he inherits was the same fan from Five Nights at Freddy's.
That'd make a lot of sense. Even though Fan Rotom is the most useless Rotom there ever was.
Indeed.
Who puts Levitate on a flying type?
Who knows?
I always wondered, wow, is Pokedex Rotom actually going to be used in battle? He's not.
Which is a shame, but to be fair, I can live with it to an extent.
Yeah. By the way, a lot of people found this the creepiest Pokedex entry about Gengar. It says, Pokedex says, should you feel yourself attacked by a sudden chill, it's evidence of approaching Gengar. There is no escaping it. Give up.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just like, yeah, thanks, guys. Much appreciated.
But what's most interesting is that the Moon One, I think, does a Mystery Dungeon reference.
Oh?
It apparently wishes for a traveling companion. Since it was once human itself, it tried to create one by taking the lives of other humans.
Interesting.
Except there's no mention of Ninetales.
Hmm. Oh, actually, speaking of Ninetales, if we get a Red and Blue Rescue Team remake, which I kind of hope we do because it was a good game, it just needed a few extra things. Like, imagine Red and Blue Rescue Team with things like the auto restore before battles like you could in Explorers.
Right.
But as one thing though, if we do get that remake, change Ninetales into Alolan Ninetales. Because you find Ninetales on Mount Freeze.
What I'm thinking that might happen, they'll make a new Mystery Dungeon game. Possibly for the Switch. Possibly.
Hopefully.
Yeah, and I speculate they're just going to reuse the walking animations and the models from Gen 7.
I believe you just stole my theory, because I was the one who told you that.
Yeah. Well, I'm not really stealing it, I'm believing it.
Yeah. One thing though, how'd you find the island trials for Sun and Moon?
I mean, I'm not sure if I like them better than gym battles, although they were enjoyable and way more immersive now.
Yeah.
And
I think they would have been really good working alongside gym battles just to help make the world feel a lot bigger.
Yeah, but sometimes...
But on their own, they're still really good.
Yeah, sometimes they're like, oh, I want to battle even though I have Pokemon, but I'll battle you later, I guess, if you want that gym battle experience. But they never tell you where they're going, so you just kind of have to find them. And when I first learned I could battle the normal type trial captain again, I was way too overleveled anyway.
Me too. Who is your favorite trial captain, though? And favorite trial?
That's a tough one. Favorite trial captain? It's either a mix between Lana and Acerola.
Me too, honestly.
So we have both the same one. Favorite trial, because it was so difficult, I like the wishy-washy one.
The wishy-washy one I didn't have too much of an issue with, but that's because I had a Rowlet.
True. I mean, I had a Litten. I didn't Z-move Mimikyu. What are you talking about? I didn't forget about Mimikyu's disguise and totally did not use the Z-move on the first turn.
Me too. Don't worry. but, yeah, and I did really like how they were all slightly different, had their really good moments. Like, Lana's one had a really good Jaws reference to it with the giant wishy-washy.
Yeah, it was great.
Acerola's one was a really good ghost moment. It was like, wait, what are you talking about? There is no back room. What? And when you go back into it, like, there's no back room. It's like, there was one right here!
I love Acerola's trial because you just have to take pictures, and the Pokefinder is kind of one of my favorite aspects of this game.
Have you max leveled it yet?
Not yet, because that's really hard to do, and I'm still trying to find that picture of Espeon. Or Umbreon.
You can get one of it. I didn't even know you could get either of those. But
yeah
I think you need something like 1 million likes to get the max level, at least.
It's 1,500,000 or something like that.
Yay.
But I remember when I was in doing the ghost trial, I was looking at all the pictures of Mimikyu, and I'm like, where's Mimikyu? I turn around, he's like right
there. Ah!
I literally screamed. I screamed because I didn't expect to find Mimikyu. Well, I mean, I kind of expected, but I love Mimikyu.
Yeah. Just don't look underneath that cloth.
It will give you nightmares. And it also might kill you, according to the Pokedex. It's true.
Yeah. One trial that I did particularly like, just because of... It was a very easy one, but just because of how stupid it was. Kiyoway's trial. The first one, you go, okay, this one's the one that's out of place. Second photo, well, where'd you come from? Why are you photobombing? Third one. Another photobomber, really?
Really, Salazzle? You just had to take up the majority of the frame there.
Yeah, and also the hiker one was, and where... I read it at first as if Kiyoway enslaved the hiker.
Okay.
I don't know why, but I was like, oh, now that, you have to battle my hiker. Your hiker!
That hiker is a meme now.
Yeah.
Oh, it's great.
Yeah. Will admit, though, the hardest trial I had, just because of how unlucky I was the first time around, Lurantis.
Yeah, oh, that trial was difficult.
Mallow's trial.
And when and the entry to Lurantis was kind of terrifying, actually.
I didn't think it was that bad, but that might just be because we had a similar moment with Wishy Washy.
I mean, true, but I mean, Wishy Washy went right for you. Lurantis was just kind of sneaking in the back.
True.
And I didn't realize how big Lurantis was.
Yeah, well, Mimikyu's one. I didn't realize how big that Mimikyu was, though.
I mean, Mimikyu. According to, like, the, what was it? According to the Pokemon Finder thing, he's about as big as your shin, maybe. Like,
he looks like he looked like he was up to my waist.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, but in like, the Pokemon battle, because I was using Incineroar, he looked really fat.
Yeah.
But I don't think Pokemon battles, like, do Pokemon sizes justice. Like, Wailord, for example.
We've increased our resolution and changed the battle specs, so why can't we render Wailord's true size?
We can't do it. Maybe they'll do it for the Switch.
Maybe, along with bringing back things like triple battles, because they are completely gone in this one.
Oh, yeah. Although, I don't care about triple battles. Are rotation battles gone, too?
Yeah, they had to be. They would have had to be. If they can't get six Pokemon rendered on screen, then rotation battles are gone too.
Yeah,
but I did like rotation battles a lot more than triple battles, so I'd like rotations to come back.
Yeah, the only issue with Sun and Moon, it looks beautiful, but my god.
The 3DS can barely run it.
Yeah, this is like the Gen 4 of 3DS games.
Yeah. You can tell it can handle a lot of things just fine, but when you get to double battles, it slows down, and I was running it on the new 3DS XL, brand new, even because it was the Sun and Moon one.
Yeah, it's even more unoptimized than X and Y.
Yeah.
I mean, I remember doing rotation battles a lot, because that's how I trained my Pokemon. When certain Pokemon comes out, oh, the game lags so badly. And even in single battles, during certain moves in Sun and Moon, you can see the slowdown.
You can, but on the plus side, from what I've heard, there were people who got the demo for Sun and Moon running on the Wii U, and apparently it looks fantastic on the Wii U. So it looks like it feels like it was actually designed to be a Switch game, but because the Switch was getting delayed again, they ported it to the 3DS.
That's why that's why Stars is a rumor now,
likely,
isn't it?
Yeah, a likely rumor.
Yeah. I would get Stars, and I'm actually looking forward to the Switch.
Me too. Still need some more information, though. That's conclusive information, because we've gone conflicting rumor after conflicting rumor after conflicting rumor after conflicting rumor, and just, what is this thing supposed to do? What can it do?
I don't know. I think we're finally going to have our answers in January.
Hopefully.
And then I heard it was supposed to release in March.
Yeah. I'm actually in a competition at the moment to see if I can get a ticket to the Melbourne Switch event, because they're bringing Switch demos here.
Nice.
So, hopefully.
Oh, one more question about the trials. What is the easiest trial for you?
The easiest one would have had to have been in Illima's.
Really?
Especially in Moon. Get something like a Crabrawler? No chance.
I mean, after the first one, because the first one is always going to be one of the easiest.
True, and the second island was kind of weird because you started off with water, then you went to fire, then you went to grass, then you went to rock. So you always had the Z crystal that was strong against the next trial.
Except for water, because water was the first one.
Yeah, but water's got enough weaknesses that you can work around it. So.
Oh yeah. Enough weaknesses? All it has is, all water is weak to is grass and electric. But then again, you can pick up Pichu on the first island, so.
Yeah.
And you can pick up a Jolteon if you wanted.
I don't think you can get Jolteon before you go up against Lana's trial. I think that one comes after.
Oh, Route 5, you mean?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Like, not too far after, but after.
Alright. Easiest trial for me, because Mimikyu is busted in this game. Literally busted for Mimikyu. Dragon.
Yeah, that was actually another really easy one, but that's because dragons stand no chance against my Rabombi.
Oh, Rabombi was such a good Pokemon too, but I replaced mine with Mimikyu.
Yeah, I couldn't find Mimikyu straight away, so I didn't put it in my party. But I did get Rabombi, and because I wasn't running Primarina, it got to be used, and used well, and I love it.
Nice.
Until I got to the mountain, and when it got quickly replaced by Ninetales.
Aw, poor Rabombi.
I still love you, Rabombi, it's just that I love Ninetales more.
Alright, how about the island kahunas? Best one, personality and what is it, design-wise and whatever.
I'm not sure, honestly, because Hala was a really good first one.
Yeah.
But nothing too much than that, other than his relation to Hao. Olivia was kind of
forgettable.
Forgettable in terms of personality, and that not really forgettable in comparison to all the other female characters Game Freak has ever put out in a Pokemon game.
Right.
She's got a very distinct look. The dark type one, who I can't even remember his name.
I have it up. His name is Nanu.
Nanu. Like, he was forgettable as well, but he did have a really good moment after you completed after you cleared the Elite Four champion.
Mm-hmm.
Which I want to get to that later, because that's a nice bit of attention to detail.
I mean,
I want to say the best one would have to be the one for Pony Island, the ground type one.
Her name is Hapu.
Hapu.
I mean, Hapu did do the most, although I do like Nanu, because I relate with him. He has a bunch of Alolan Meowth in his house, and basically does nothing, really not much against Team Skull, except close off an entire town.
Give him props for trying.
Yeah, and he's the uncle of Ace Rolla.
Yeah. I guess the issue with Nanu is that Acerol is just so good of a character that he kind of gets overshadowed.
Overshadowed by his own niece.
Yeah.
Uncle Nanu is like the most disinterested cat lover you would ever meet.
Indeed.
Although I do like Hapu. She's really cool.
Yeah.
And Hala's cool too. I don't mind him either.
No, he is really good. All four of them are really good, so I think Hapu just barely beats out them all overall. Yeah, just because she has a lot more of an importance.
Yeah, I remember having a bit of trouble on Hapu's trial, but I did have Wishiwashi as my water type.
Yeah, I didn't really have too much trouble with any of the trainers. The only time I had any trouble with them is if I wasn't prepared properly because I was grinding, in the case of the first battle against Guzma, and then I quickly curb stomped him after, alright, when he got my real team.
Mm-hmm.
And the other time I struggled was against Red, but that's because I had fought every trainer at that route to that point except for the Fairy Trial Captain again, and my team was almost dead.
Right.
They had no chance.
And you know, and what do you think of Z moves and Z crystals? Because I want to talk about my little issue with their choice of the Elite Four.
When you earn the crystals by completing challenges, they were really good. Other ones like the flying crystal, eh.
You mean the ones that you just find like randomly in the wild?
Yeah, like the flying one I feel like was thrown in there at the last possible moment because they had nowhere else to put it.
Flying, psychic, and ice were the ones.
The ice one at least makes sense because it's on the ice mountain.
Yeah, it's like, where do we put the flying one? What was the flying elite for? Kahili? Kahili, where did we put the flying one? I don't know, I just kind of launched it with my golf. I thought it was a golf ball, so it's somewhere. I don't know where.
Yeah, it's in a and she somehow managed to get it in a pedestal up on the, up inside of a dormant volcano. On another island.
Wow, you really knocked it far.
Like, damn, that's a good shot.
Okay, psychic made sense. You know where psychic was?
Wasn't that one in the desert?
Yeah, it was in the desert. That one makes a little bit of sense because that's hard to reach. And
yeah.
And I guess you can call it a mirage. So.
True. And you're going there anyway because right near where you'd get the crystal is where you find Tapu Bulu. So you're going down there anyway. But the flying one, you need to have Machamp, which you get as the last possible ride Pokemon in the game. Go back to 10 Carat Hill, and then take a side path upwards in order to get to the crystal.
Well, you do have to do a little bit of work with that crystal anyway. I guess that's why the flying one is all the way here.
Yeah.
I mean, Dragon, because Dragon never had a trial captain. Dragon is lonely. Dragon, Flying, Psychic, and Ice are up for grabs. What would you be the trial captain of?
I'd be the one for Ice.
Sweet. I guess I'll take Flying.
You're not going to take Dragon because of your Mega Salamence, who will kill you?
True. I guess I'll take either Dragon or... Honestly, Psychic looks pretty fun, too.
Yeah, I'll take Psychic or Ice, just because I do like those two types.
Yeah, actually, I'll take Dragon, because I usually used Dragonite and Salamence a lot.
Get yourself a Mother Reverend Dragonite!
Oh, I love those videos.
They were so good.
What did you think of the Elite Four when you finally got up to it?
I kind of expected a lot of the kahunas to come back in for the final challenge because they seemed like they would have been the right ones, and two of them were right. And Acerola, I did love fighting, I think just because of her little dances she was waiting for you to make you move.
Yeah, I love Acerola. She's one of my favorites.
Yeah. The flying one is...
Where did you come from?
You're a former... trial clearer who plays golf and... Okay.
They need someone for flying. Why flying? Flying is like the easiest one to take down, isn't it?
Yeah, and not to mention I had a Alolan Raichu with Stoked Surfster.
I mean, you stand
no chance.
She just looks a bit lazy too. They just took the golfer the golfer trainer class and just made into a gym leader.
Yeah.
Well, Elite Four member, but you know.
I will say, though, I did like the champion one. Because there is no champion in Alola yet when you start the game.
Right.
When you get up to the champion's room, you have to sit down on your throne first, and then Kukui comes out saying, you are the champion, but we've got one more final challenge for you. Meaning that you're not versing the champion, you're defending your title as the champion. The battle champion theme is your theme. And
that
they even start off with the... They even have it as a nice bit of attention to detail for all the fans. The first part of the song is the da 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 da.
That was the that theme was actually the was it the trailer theme for Sun and Moon?
Yeah.
That's great. This is more of a mind blow than when I learned that realization in Undertale, the end of Genocide. I'm the boss.
Spoilers for Undertale!
That game's like a year old anyway.
People still complain that everything about Undertale's a spoiler.
The thing is, the creator of Undertale is like, no spoilers until this game's a year old. And now the game's a year old, so I can say whatever I want.
Yeah. The other thing as well with the champions one is that the final battle is completely randomized. You could fight Kukui again, you could fight Gideon, you could fight Plumeria, you could fight Hao, you could fight anybody.
Yeah. Well, anybody that comes up.
Yeah, and that's really good because, again, you're not trying to take the champion's title, you're defending your title.
And that, I love that aspect of the Elite Four.
Yeah. I'm surprised it took them 20 years to do that.
It takes you 20 years to get from age 10 to age 11.
At least we were a year older than Ash, who went from 10 to 11, back to 11, and then went back to 10 and just stayed there.
Wait, how did he devolve to 10?
I don't know. But they've made at least two references going, it's been a year since I was last here, and it's been a year since we first met, Pikachu. It's like, wait, that means time's passed. You can't be 10.
It's been a year. Do you think Ash lies about his age?
Probably. Hell, even Jesse and James have said we've been doing this for a lot longer than you've existed, Dawn. It's like,
well, that's
you true. Know!
Well, that's true.
Yeah, they're not wrong.
I could imagine, if I were a champion, I would make a lot of changes. It's like, okay, so this is my room. This is my champion's room, and I can do whatever I want. And then I'd imagine like someone would walk up and they'd be like, what's with all the plushes? It's my room! I can do whatever I want.
And now I can put these plushes here because my cat, my pet Meowth, is not going to claw into them.
Isn't that right, Meowth?
Oh, one thing I did really like is that you can actually get an awakening pretty early in the game. All you have to do is just go back to sleep in your house, Meowth will wake you up, and then give you an awakening.
Here's what I don't understand about the game. They remove sitting in on chairs from X and Y and Oros, and then they replace it with sleeping on beds with a very description of each bed you sleep in. Who added this?
Who knows? It's probably the same one who decided we can dance by spinning.
Which makes for searching for Pokemon a little bit more annoying if you're not riding on a Pokemon.
Yeah. It's a really funny way of getting your eggs hatched really quickly. A little hole just in front of the daycare. Well, not the daycare anymore, the...
It's called a nursery.
The nursery. A little hole in there which you have to walk into first, but once you're inside the hole, you can get Tauros out. And Tauros cannot escape. So just run around in circles, holding down the B, so Tauros continues charging, and it will all count as steps.
What I usually do with Tauros is just charge into the fence, and just kind of move up and down. I would need to hop off Taurus and hop back on Taurus. I just hop on Taurus and just do that.
That works too. I just find it funny that you're seeing a Taurus charging around at full speed in a little hole.
There's so much art behind that. It's like the person just charging in that little hole.
That's hilarious.
And they're going, "Sis, look, that weird trainer's at it again." Did you see any of that? Hello? Okay.
You there?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yay! Yes, I can.
I had no idea what happened. It just randomly blacked and dropped.
Yeah. Skype!
Anyway, what were we talking about?
Well, I was doing the intermission thing.
You're still recording, right?
Yes, I am.
Good. But what were we talking about?
Taurus.
Oh yeah, Taurus. But I said, there's so much art of that, of Taurus riding in that little hole, and one of the breeders going, "Sis, look at this, that weird kitty doing it again."
What do you think of ride Pokemon, though, overall?
It makes things, like, so much easier, actually. Some ride Pokemon replace key... Well, ride Pokemon replace key items, and the best part of it is they replace HMs.
Yeah, and some of them are quite good, others are kind of useless. I would have rather had the item finder rather than Stoutland.
I don't mind Stoutland. At least it makes things a little bit quicker.
Actually, I found it slower compared to the item finder.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I do miss the item finder from Oros, because that was the best item finder.
Indeed. Tauros I got a lot of use out of because it's your bike, basically.
A bike.
And it can learn Rock Smash.
A bike and Rock Smash. Tauros has to be the best one.
Yeah. Sharpedo got a lot of use once I got him because I have a jet ski now.
Yeah, I think Lapras is actually better use than Sharpedo because you can't fish off a Sharpedo.
True, but if I'm using a Sharpedo, I'm going from point A to point B, and you can somehow call upon a different ride Pokemon while you're in the water, so...
Right. Wait, I never knew that, actually.
Yeah.
Like, in the middle of the water, you could just switch from Sharpedo to Lapras?
Yeah.
That's sweet.
Game logic!
Woo! This is the first game you will ever see. TM Fly.
Wait, that means it does nothing now. Aww.
Now it's completely useless.
Well, it's still... Fly is still a good move, so...
I'm gonna break this TM. Nah.
At least Fly is still a good move, like Surf and Strength. It's moves like Cut, Flash, Defog that are completely useless.
Well, actually, Defog's a really good competitive move now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Defog gets rid of entry hazards.
Yeah.
And lowers accuracy. I think. Oh no, it lowers evasion or accuracy. It must be evasion.
Who knows?
Oh, find that out right now, actually. Is there anything that you didn't like from Sun and Moon?
Honestly, it felt very tutorial-heavy on Melee Island.
Yeah.
And everyone keeps saying this, it's still true. Kukui, I get it. Lily, Illima, all that stuff, I do get it. I get why you do it. But I've been catching Pokemon since before you were programmed. I've been using status conditions before you were programmed. I know how to do this.
I just didn't like how the trainer
give me the option to skip.
I wish that the trainer school was kind of skippable, but I mean, if you want to learn more if you don't know how to do the game, The text is all in the trainer school. Like, the tutorial is all in the trainer school there, but I'm still kind of bummed that... Gen 2 was the first game I could actually skip the, how to catch a Pokemon.
No, that was Gen 1. They did it in Gen 1 and then just ditched it entirely. Because we got missing no out of it.
True.
So why are you guys just not despawning the tutorial after we skip it?
I don't know. I was actually watching the anime, and then I learned that Lusamine was confirmed, and now it's just heartbreaking to even see Lily.
Yeah.
Lily. I'm just crying over Lily now.
Yeah, and... while we're on the subject of the anime, we may as well talk about the one thing that's been taking hold of all the talk about it so far. The shipping wars.
Pokemon Sun and Moon has just been waifu wars.
Yeah.
I mean, since that huge thing that happened with Serena. Huge, gigantic, breakthrough. Like, breaking ground. Then you go to Sun and Moon, where there's just so many characters.
And all of them want your attention.
Is Sun and Moon a dating simulator?
I think it will be now.
Well, who are you gonna date?
D, none of the above.
No, you have to pick someone.
But I've only watched two episodes, I've only watched two episodes and that clip of Lana's sisters going, sure.
Oh no, come on, Lana. Lana, I love you, but come on. Okay, well, are any of the characters...
Lana shouldn't even be into Ash. She's looking for swimmers. He's not a swimmer.
I don't think he can swim. Now, he can swim with the aid of Sharpedo.
Oh, and he has swum in earlier... Oh, wait, no, he hasn't swum yet, because every time they go to a new season, it's a reboot.
Yeah.
What is this Jhoto you speak of?
No, I was amazed, because Ash actually recognizes Pokemon Sun and Moon.
Indeed, including ones that he's never seen before.
Wait, like who?
I think he recognized Turtonator.
No, he didn't. He asked, what is that Pokemon?
The next thing he said is, so that's a Turtonator. So well, he's at least heard of the species.
I think he heard of it from Kauai.
Kukui.
No, not Kukui, the fire.
Oh, Kiwi.
Kiwi, yeah, he heard from him.
Kiwi's a fruit, Kiwi.
His name is now Kiwi.
Oh, goddammit.
Kiwi. Are you happy now?
Yes.
I like Lana. Lana's the best. She's like so... She likes to look so sad, but is actually really strong.
Yeah.
And
then, of course, there's Lily, who's the... I can touch Pokemon if I want to, I just don't want to.
Oh, Lily, don't be a tsundere.
Yes. I'm not too sure what to say about Mallow yet, because, again, I've only seen two episodes, and the most... backstory she's had so far is that she cooks.
I guess we need a Mallow-centric episode before we can say anything from it.
At least on the plus side, from what I've seen so far of Mallow, she's not a new Cylon. Even though she's a grass-type user who cooks.
And I was afraid of Mallow. Oh, I was afraid
that she was going to win the shipping wars, and then it'll just be female Cylon.
Who do you think went? I wonder who won. I think Lily won the shipping wars, actually.
I'm not sure yet, because I'm still waiting on Sun and Moon to get to episode 3 in the English dub, which reminds me I need to catch up on the X and Y show. Well, yeah. XYZ.
Yeah, I was watching the sub because I didn't want to wait.
I'm fine with waiting, but that's because I've still got XYZ to get through.
Although
Whereas you finished XYZ.
Yeah, although I can say that the dub for Sun and Moon is actually pretty good.
It is good, and as I said in my first impressions post for it, the only real issue I have with it at the moment is Ash's design himself, because everyone else looks like they've come straight from the game.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that Ash that feels like he was kind of lost in transition.
Right.
which is a shame, but
the animation is so different because they don't follow, I guess you could say, models. I don't know what they would be in 2D, but they don't follow exact models. They're very expressive and very, like, fluid. It's almost like they have a bigger budget.
Indeed.
And it's almost feel like they're made by a different animation company. Wait, this is...
It's the same company. Just different animation tools.
Oh, okay.
Oh yeah, and I also saw something today before we started recording, which I didn't realize before.
What?
We finally have Burb Pokemon of all three types, for the starters.
Okay, you got Torchic for the fire type, Piplup for the water type, and Rowlet for the grass type.
You will love the Seedowl!
You know, I was actually thinking, if they did make a 6th-gen Mystery Dungeon game, I was thinking of it, I'm like... And I decided I'd be a Piplup with a Rowlet. And we basically...
You mean 7th-gen game, because 6th-generation game was Super Mystery Dungeon, which we will get to eventually, I swear.
I'm sorry, but for 7th-gen Mystery Dungeon, that would be mine. Because I always overthink things.
Sorry, people, we just really don't want to play Gates to Infinity because it's so bad.
Actually, I could actually think of something I didn't like from Sun and Moon.
Nabane?
The Festival Plaza. Remember that?
Oh, yeah! Let's talk about that little gem. Oh, God.
Well, I mean, there's things that I like and things that I absolutely hate about it. Things that I like, you can win bottle caps, make Eevee and level training easier. But at what cost?
The cost of being able to connect easily with your friends online. Something I thought would have been priority one for this plaza.
I mean, I miss the PSS system.
I do too, and here's how... Because it took us a while to get our game, or one of each of our games, synced up to each other so we can so that we were VIPs in each other's games. Mm-hmm. Here's how we did it. I put up a Pelipper called Postman, or Postwoman, one of the two.
Postwoman,
with a berry being held in it. Marissa had to search for that one on the global trade system, find it, trade with it. Well, global trade system, GTS.
Yeah,
same thing.
I know.
Trade it, then, as soon as we did the trade, find each other, register each other as VIPs, and then do the trade back. Wait, did we trade back, or...?
I mean, I think we trade back because we were trading each other items as well.
Oh yeah, that was the reason why we were doing it in the first place.
Yeah.
Because... One, at least on the plaza side, there is one thing I do really like, but we'll get to that after we finish with the festival plaza.
Okay.
The plaza itself is... You can tell it's designed more for playing with random people online rather than playing with your friends.
And trying to find your friends is near to impossible.
Unless they're right next to you in real life.
Yeah.
Which, seeing as you live in America, and I live in Australia where there's two oceans between us, that's kind of impossible.
And, yeah, it's hard. I thought this game was all about bringing friends together all over the world, like, it's not.
You'd think that, but apparently not. Unless you're looking for new friends, in which case, yes, it is, but...
But... Other than that, no.
Yeah. Apparently not, no.
So. Okay. And what we get to after the Festival Plaza?
One feature I did really like, the Pokepelago.
I thought you were going to talk about that. Yeah, I love the Pokepelago. The fact that you can EV train Pokemon gives almost no excuse to say, oh, I don't know how to EV, I don't have time to EV train my pokes.
Yeah, exactly. And not to mention, this is the first game where I've gone into the berry system. I've got hundreds of berries now, something that I couldn't even do in Generation 3 in Emerald.
Yeah, everything is so much easier in with the Pokepelagio.
I now have enough berries to feed my Pokemon a natural diet of berries and never need to use ethers, elixirs, and potions ever again.
I mean, I have like almost over 200 Lepa berries, but I've been kind of slacking on the berries, which I shouldn't.
Yeah, I have too.
But
wait, did Sky just drop again?
The berries are actually kind of buffed in this game because some berries they were from Gen 3. I don't know, but they like some berries take away EVs, and that's really good.
God
when
damn it, Skype.
It lagged out again. Why is it lagging out again? Why am I lagging out?
Try three!
What?
Try three with this damn call.
I have no idea why it keeps lagging out. Like...
Yeah, I don't know. Is this Skype or something else? Just... Why?
Let me try to do this. Okay, I ended a background... I'm ending, like, some Steam background processes, even though Steam is closed. I hate when it does this.
Yeah, you're not the only one.
Steam, stop. But, as I was talking about berries, there's berries that, like, remove EVs, so it's really easy if you wanna if you wanna level up your Pokemon first before you EV train, but of course I try to EV train my Pokemon before I level them up.
Yeah, so you can get full use of them.
Yeah. IVs are actually much easier in this game to actually check for.
Yeah.
I remember, the way you get the IV checker is actually really funny. You have to go to the end of the game to go to the battle tree. There's a guy there that's half asleep and there's like, oh, would you like me to check your potential for your Pokemon? Ah, screw this. Here, you can check your IVs yourself. I'm going home.
Well, that works too.
That's basically how it happened.
Yeah. That works too.
Thanks. That's great.
Indeed. Speaking of the battle tree, I have to admit that's the one thing I haven't really gone into yet, but that's because I'm waiting for the bank.
Yeah. I'm trying to train my Pokemon, trying to get Pokemon in organization for the VGC ladder.
Yeah.
But
I plan on getting to VGC myself. I'm just waiting for next year when all Pokemon are opened up because I want to try out my Mega Gardevoir Tapu Fini combo.
VGC 2017.
Wait, no, I'm thinking of Tapu Lele. The one that boosts fairies.
Right. VGC 2017, even after Pokebank is open, I think the first VGC competition is going to be Alolan Dex only.
Yeah, that's the rules set for this year, so it's going to be 2018 when the full Pokedex is opened up.
Right. It gives me an opportunity to, like, actually try. I would love to participate in VGC, like, Worlds. I'm not sure if I can.
Don't see why you wouldn't.
I mean, Boston is drivable too, although still pretty far from me.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I forgot I had Monster Hunter 4 on my desk.
Oh, hello.
Still haven't played it.
Double Cross is coming out, like, next year, maybe. Where are you?
It's Hyrule Warriors and Sun and Moon and Shantae Half Genie Hero on my Vita mean that the Vita's finally getting some use.
Oh yeah.
Real use.
Oh yeah, my brother got a Vita, actually, and he basically said I could use the PS4, so... When is Kingdom Hearts 3 coming out?
Come on, you can't keep releasing the same games over and over again. You gotta do it sooner or later.
It's getting Persona 4.
Final Fantasy 15's done now.
You mean Cup Noodles 15?
That too.
Anything else about Sun and Moon before we get off into tangents?
There is something I do want to talk about. The music.
It's fantastic.
Yeah, a lot of it is, yes, and I really enjoy some tracks, like the Battle Red and Blue theme. Mm-hmm. Vast Pony Canyon's a really good song, the Battle Champion theme, but there is one thing that I have to knock it down a lot for.
Is it the Ride Pokemon theme?
No. Okay, two things. I hate that song.
Yeah.
But one I do hate... Cynthia. Her theme from Diamond and Pearl is back. No remix, no remaster. It is the same damn song from Diamond and Pearl.
I mean...
Why?
I mean, it's still a good song, but it's a direct rip. If, you know what else is kind of disgusting in that? One of the Frontier Brains makes an appearance. What was her name? Annabelle?
Annabelle.
The Frontier Brain from the Trinity Tower in Emerald. Her theme is in there, disgustingly ripped from Emerald. Just like GBA sound font and all.
And what makes it worse is that the Battle Elite, the Battle Frontier Brain theme was used in Auraz with a remix for the Battle Chantaloon. So why not use that one?
Why didn't... Is it because Emerald doesn't count? Emerald wasn't in Auraz? Oh my god.
Annabelle was the head of the tower in Ruby and Sapphire too!
I want my high quality trumpets! Not high quality crumpets. That's something different.
That's the one... That and the fact that they're still using MIDI files when... For the 20th anniversary, I was kind of expecting a real orchestra at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the songs themselves are good, I will not deny that. But they didn't go the extra mile for a lot of these.
Yeah.
It's just... Why?
You're one-on-one with Annabelle yet again, all the way from Emerald. The battle starts... Bow, 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 bow. Who left this Game Boy on?
Yeah, it's just... You were so close, guys. So close.
I guess I got kind of lazy about it and just took direct rips.
Yeah, or they were running out of budget, but... Even still, use the rips from the last game.
I think they forgot Auraz was a thing. Except Wally's here with his theme, so... Eh.
The Cynthia one really bothers me, though, because I love Cynthia's song, and they're teasing at Diamond and Pearl remakes. So they would have to be working on Diamond and Pearl remakes if they are teasing it. Why not use... Yeah.
One thing. I mean, Serena was an important... Serena? What? Cynthia was...
Oh, do you mean Sarina?
No, not Sarina. I want Serena and Alola, but not like this.
You'll get what we say you get, and you will love it just like you're supposed to, sheep.
Although I did like Serena as a Pokemon, but...
Unfortunately, I never got a lot of use out of it, but the weird thing is, I found 5% and 10% encounter rates in the Lush Jungle before I found a Bond Suite.
Yeah.
How?
Also, Oranguru is my new hatred because of BGC.
I still need to catch myself on Oranguru because I'm only at the trainer school in Moon at the moment. I've completed Sun, not Moon.
I have almost as much as disdain for Oranguru that I have for Wailord.
Oh, so does that mean that our new mascot for Mediaholics is going to be an Oranguru riding on a Wailord?
Oh my god! Don't trigger me like that!
Hashtag triggered.
It would make more sense for me to hate Mimikyu, but I can't hate Mimikyu even though it is very annoying.
It's just so precious.
I know. The thing is, VGC. VGC 2017. Trick Room is so prevalent.
Well, I guess that's because a lot of the Pokemon in this one are so much slower now compared to older Pokemon.
Yeah, you know what? But one thing that's interesting about the Pokedex, sorry, going off into a Pokedex tangent, the majority of Alolan Pokemon are slow, while the majority of 6th gen Pokemon were fast. So sometimes it's like, okay, slow down a bit, slow down a bit. But we have priority moves. Tabu Lele's here. Slow down a bit.
Yeah.
Oh, that poor Tabu Flame. But BGC 2017, just Trick Room is everywhere. That I'm like, okay, fine. I made an anti-Trick Room team just to try to... Just, like, I didn't want to use a Trick Room team, so I made an anti-Trick Room team.
Yeah. Also, does that mean that Talonflame's the new Hydreigon? And being that it was so good in the generation it debuted in, and then nerfed to living hell in the next one.
Yeah, it's like if Talonflame was flying, despite Stealth Rock, he's just flying high, and then all you see him in... You know, have you seen the special for, have you seen the special for X and Y with the thing that happened in the past with Xerneas and Yveltal?
Not yet.
Okay, so there was a clip from that where you see a trainer sending out Talonflame, and then because of Yveltal, turns to stone and just falls to the ground, not even seeing what happens to him. Yeah, that's Talonflame in Sun and Moon.
Wow.
That's basically what happened.
Is the team behind the games and the animation when the anime just really depressed at the moment?
I think they really hated Talonflame during the last BGC, that they're like, let's kill this bird. I just want to kill this bird.
Well, they must have done the same thing for Mega Kangaskhan, because we've ruined a family.
And Mega Kangaskhan's ability was breath, but this is because they were pretty unbalanced themselves.
Yeah.
They're just fixing balancing issues, and apparently Smogon decided, let's ban Aegislash for Sun and Moon.
Smogon.
By the way,
bloody hell, guys.
By the way, speaking of Pokemon, what do you think of the starters?
Love Rowlet and its family. Mm-hmm. Because I get to call a Pokemon Owliver Queen.
Oh, that's sweet.
And then the basic form is Blathers.
Yeah.
I've got a Lynn who I accidentally wanted to nickname, so it's now known as Ember.
Okay.
But I hate... Well, hate is a strong word. Out of the three of them, I don't like Incineroar.
Aw, I love my Incineroar. She is it's good. Mine's a
girl.
Well,
I'm not saying that it's bad. I still hate Embor a lot more. It's just that out of the three of them.
Well, at least he's not another fire.
One of them has to lose.
At least he's not another...
True that. True that. But then, of course, I've also got Sonata the Popplio, who is going to become a Primarina.
You know what's very interesting about Primarina? I don't know if this is a conspiracy. There's a singer not part of a band, who calls herself Marina and the Diamonds. And she has a song. One of her first singles was Prima Donna Girl. Is there a coincidence happening here?
Are you sure you're not just watching more of Gem and the Holograms? Because that sounds like someone out of Gem and the Holograms.
No, it's a real...
It could have come out of Gem and the Holograms.
No, it's a real singer and a real song. Look it up on YouTube later. Good song.
We watched the first five episodes of that show, and we had bands known as Misfits and Gem and the Holograms. Just that name instantly reminds me of that show.
Oh, Marina and the Diamonds. Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah.
I mean, if you want, you could get Primarina and name her Jen.
No.
Why? Because the movie... I'm not sure if it's the movie or the show that made you mad.
The movie's now beaten Age of Extinction as the worst thing I've reviewed for Mediaholics. It beat Age of Extinction.
Aren't you glad that I mentioned that movie to you?
I am, but I'm not. Because now I'm waiting to see if Michael Bay wants his title back.
Oh, maybe he's gonna try to win it back with another terrible movie.
Well, seeing as we've got a movie that has mini Dinobots, Unicron, Nemesis Prime, a Headmaster, a character who has a French accent that somehow turns into two cars.
Okay.
Because that's a redundant triple changer. What used to be a tank carrier truck is now just a normal pickup truck. Okay. And...
We'll have to see what happens.
And also the trailer showed off that we're going to be going to places like playing Arthurian Legend and the Nazis.
What? I'm terrified.
What terrifies me is that I had to have those in the same sentence. Like, it's not just one or the other. We're getting both. And modern times.
Double the prizes? Double the fun?
Ich bin nein Benina! Heil Hydra!
Oh no. Oh, by the way.
I have no idea what I just said.
Something.
Other than Heil Hydra.
Something in German. But, Can you take a wild guess which Pokemon appeared in VGC the most of the three Final Evolution starters?
Decidueye?
Nope.
Incineroar?
Yep. He's actually pretty bulky.
Nice.
And can learn a range of moves like Snarl, Outrage, Flare Blitz. Darkestlarian is actually really good.
Yeah.
And
I remember, to go back to the Z-moves for a little bit, very quickly, because Z-moves are getting used a lot in VGC, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
How do you find the moves themselves? Not the crystals, but the moves themselves.
Well, their animations are beautiful.
Indeed, and some of them are really, really weird, like Mew attacking with a DNA helix.
Well, that's Mew's special one, which isn't even, like, released yet.
No, it's not, but people have hacked it in. And of course, yeah. So we know about it.
Well, my...
There's also your favorite one that I saw you use. Z-Splash, which you taught to Solgaleo.
Solgaleo, yes! Yes, I love it! You could only get it when you, spoiler, evolve it from Cosmog.
Yep.
It's actually really useful, and people use it in, like, real battles.
It's just that when you first think of it, you go, wait, Z-Splash, really?
And then you go down, it's like, oh, look at that, a plus 3 attack up.
Well, it's not the weirdest one I've seen. There are other ones that have got really weird names, like Catastropica, Twinkling Tackle.
I mean, I love 10,000, what was it? 10,000 volt or something like that.
I think it was a million volt, something like that.
A million volt. I'm gonna go to Z moves.
You do that.
Yeah, I love that because he just nukes the whole place.
Yeah, another one that I find absolutely hilarious. Mm-hmm. The rock type attacking one, because you just drop a mountain on your opponent.
Yeah. One of my favorite ones is Never Ending Nightmare, just because of the name.
Yeah. Oh, another one, just for animations, is Pulverizing Pummel.
Yeah. Although I must admit, that one looks a little bit lazy.
The laziest one I have to say is Toucanon Sky Strike.
Oh, Sky Strike.
I'm too much of a badass to even flap my wings.
If you think that's bad, you know who else can learn... You know who else can learn the Z flying move?
Snorlax?
No. I guess.
Oh, Wailord too.
Yeah, Wailord.
I don't need to fly to use a flying type Z move.
Bombs away!
And to be fair, we are talking about a series where a bird that doesn't have wings can learn fly, but a dragon with wings can't.
We're talking...
Pokemon that are rock ground types with a 4x weakness to water can learn surf. That makes sense.
This is the same series where you have a fire flying type and a water flying type that are really dragons but really not dragons, and then you see the tallest palm tree with three faces, and that's a dragon type.
Charizard, not a dragon type.
Gyarados,
not a dragon type. Dragonair, not fully realized dragon type. Goomy, dragon type. Exeggutor, dragon type. Wait, what?
this Goomy's a little baby dragon. What is that? Exeggutor. That is...
How does evolution work? How do you evolution?
I think Gen 7 has probably the best looking, the best looking legend and the most useful legendary Pokemon of any of them. Except for, I guess, Necrozma.
Yeah.
I mean, what?
Oh, actually, speaking of that, because Necrozma you can only get after you do the quest. How'd you find the Ultra Beasts?
They were pretty interesting. And interesting if you consider, like, consider this. The Ultra Beasts might be based on the Seven Deadly Sins.
Indeed. I have seen that theory as well, so I know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Best one and worst one?
Best one? I really like Circuitry.
Yeah, Circuitry's hilarious.
It's
a bunch of wires. That's a tree. And let's call it Circuitry.
I mean...
Done.
I do like Circuitry for the design and the usability. But if we're just going by design, I'm not sure. I mean, even with the usability, I do like Paper Mario. I mean, Cartana.
I freaking hate Cartana. It was a nightmare to get all four of those guys for me. Because they would one-shot my team. The area where I had to find them was so big that it took ages for them to spawn. To the point where I had to go out and get a Magnemite with Magnet Pull just to make them come to me. And again, they would one-shot my entire freaking team. And until recently, I had no idea that Beast Balls acted like Master Balls to the Pokemon. Ultra Beast,
You never used Beast Balls?
Oh no, I used Beast Balls, but I thought they were more like the equivalent of Ultra Balls for Ultra Beasts, not Master Balls for Ultra Beasts.
Near to Master Balls.
Yeah, so I did it legit, and I had fun catching all of them, because they were some entertaining catches that I'd never had since Gen 4.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, Gen 5. So, yeah, like, they were fun to catch, it's just Cartana was pain in the ass.
I'm kind of sad about the Celestela I caught, because I need a modest Celestela. I don't, like, I caught a careful Celestela, which is good for it's sub-seeding for singles, but I need a modest Celestela. And now I can't get mine.
Not unless you reset the game.
Oh, one of my favorite ones is Pheromoza. Oh no, I remember now. Favorite in design is Buzzwole.
Yeah, I could see that. Yeah, that one was okay. I think the one I've had the most use out of because of how bulky he is... I forget the name of him off the top of my head, but Glutton.
His name is... Well, I hadn't lost it, like, in my head.
Yeah,
Guzzlord. Like, his name is Guzzlord.
Guzzlord, that's it. Just because how bulky he is, like, mine's got close to, like, 500 health.
A lot of people say Guzzlord is kind of the laziest design because he's just so generic.
Fat.
Yeah, but he's like a generic RPG monster that eats things.
Considering as the Ultra Beasts are just meant to be wild things that have no real relation to Pokemon, but they are still Pokemon.
Mm-hmm.
They're just different kinds. I'm fine with Guzzlord. In terms of design, like, he's meant to be different from a Pokemon.
Right.
Okay, I'll think of him as something different, and he still looks kind of cool.
Yeah, I do like that mouth. I mean, who designed? Did different people design the Ultra Beasts because they just don't look like Pokemon?
Probably.
But at the same time as well, they
were probably designed with the mentality of these don't have to look like Pokemon, they can be whatever you want them to be. Go nuts.
Right. I'm looking at the official art for the Ultra Beasts, and all of them look so intimidating, like they're ready to like kill something. And then you go over to Circuitry, which looks like he's dancing.
Oh, we found a new partner for Ludicolo.
You know what I
and also a new Pokemon for Tieno's team.
Oh, true. Here, I'm gonna send you the official Ultra Beast artwork. Do you have like specific names for your Ultra Beasts, or do you just keep them all unnicknamed?
I keep them all unnicknamed unless I can think of a clever nickname, like Owliver or Blathers for the Rowlet family. I don't nickname my Pokemon.
I mean, I've like three nicknames for ones I use. Pheromosa, I just kind of call Lusamine because she looks like Lusamine.
Yeah.
I mean, Celestia is the one that I use the most, and her name's just Sloth because I couldn't think of anything good. Kartana's Paper Mario, but I had to get a different one, so now I can't name him. But Circuitry, and Circuitry's name is Rick, because I've watched a lot of Rick and Morty, and now he looks like Rick, so Circuitry is Rick.
okay, Morty, we got. I can't do a Morty. I can't do a Rick voice.
Morty, you gotta give me a Pokemon, Morty. So many people looked at Guzma and they just made Guzma into Rick. There is a GIF. Not kidding, there is a GIF that you can find, which is just Guzma in the style of Rick and Morty doing the Get Schwifty dance. Let me do it for you.
Jeez.
It is so good.
And here I thought the funniest thing from Rick and Morty in terms of cameos I would see is when the Rick and Morty team did the Simpsons couch gag.
Oh, I saw that. That was great.
What did you do, Morty? You killed the Simpsons, Morty!
Oh, you killed the Simpsons, Morty! They're such a good family! Oh, you killed the... Oh, look at them! They're all crushed! Oh, Morty, what'd you do? Also,
That's it! No more guest animators!
By the way, you just sent me the gift.
Cool. I'll take a look at it now.
I just remembered about Poopy. I just remembered about Poopy move.
Pukumuku?
What is the most disturbing Pokemon? Like, the new Pokemon?
I'd have to say Pukumuku, because I'm looking at this GIF now and it's just... What are those grunts doing?
They're using them as, tambourines. But you know how Pukumuku has, like, that thing where he just makes a hand out of his inner intestines?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks for the imagery, guys. Much appreciated.
I mean, at first, the first time I saw Pukumuku was the introduction to him, and all you see is just the image of Pukumuku and the description that says he can attack with his inner organs. I'm looking at Pukumuku so terrified of how that's going to be animated. But
ew.
But then it turned out to be kind of cute.
Yeah. Because this is Pokemon, and visually it's meant to be cute, but on the inside it is dark and depressing, and you might affect your very well-being.
Thank you, Pikachu and Mimikyu. Okay, one thing I actually don't like about Sun and Moon. Shiny Pokemon. Not finding them. The actual shiny Pokemon.
Yeah, and immediately the way to get them as well is kind of annoying, but I'll save that for in a moment. Yeah, a lot of the shinies don't look very good.
The main reason why is because now in Sun and Moon, actually back in 6th Gen they could have done this too, it's not just palette change anymore. You could change whatever part of it you want to be changed. That can be...
Yeah, and they did do it for Generation 6 as well, to an extent. But not all Pokemon. With this one, they did it for all Pokemon, to my knowledge. All the new stuff, at least.
Yeah, I think there are only some Pokemon that don't get, like, that thing where it's just oh, your highlights have changed, or oh, your base has changed. It's not ever base and highlights anymore. It's either base or highlights.
Yeah.
I like what they did for the Tapu shiny that aren't released yet. That's good, but what's a shiny I don't like? I want to look at shiny Pokemon.
One shiny I like because I caught it was Mudbray, and I didn't even mean to catch it, but now it is mine. Why was the first thing I thought of when I talked like that was Yahtzee?
I don't know. Okay. Oh, what was a shiny Pokemon that I hated?
For the record, unless last night is genuinely that bad, I am not doing another CinemaSins Yahtzee review like that again. But I'm not doing another 50-page review for a movie. Not happening.
Okay. I'm
putting my foot down. Unless it is that bad somehow, I am not doing it. And considering my standards for the last night, the only way it could disappoint me is if it was a 3-hour photo of a corpse with the sign, "Fuck you, we took your money." That is the only way it would disappoint me, and even then I'd be kind of impressed if they had the balls to do it.
You okay now?
Yeah, I'm good.
Okay. Shinies I didn't like about Sun Moon because they were too lazy. I guess Savali, because he was just so... just subtle. Shinies are supposed to be, like, bright and colorful and very noticeable, but... What?
Can you even get a shiny type null?
Yes, you can actually. Type null is not shiny left, surprisingly.
Well, it's the same as ours then, like. But then, what is shiny locked in this game?
Shiny locked, I think. Oh, yeah, the starters are not shiny locked. Cosmog is shiny locked. And the Tapus.
Well, that's not too bad, at least.
Yeah. I think that's it. Sorry. Ultra Beasts are shiny locked, and I think the Zygarde is shiny locked.
Oh.
Yeah. Ultra Beasts are probably have the one of the best shinies, but it's a shame they're shiny locked. Except for Buff Bug over here, his highlights just get green, and that's it.
Yeah. So, does it mean that one of us is probably going to be hacking in the game to get those shinies? Because there's no way those shinies are coming outside Japan.
That's a shame. I would love a shiny Guzzlord.
Me too.
That's never going to be, though. What else? Oh, one of my favorites is shiny Alolan Muk, which the green part just becomes purple like a normal Muk.
Oh god, the acid trip's even harder. The colors! The colors!
I mean, I randomly was walking, getting Guzzlord, and right after I get Guzzlord, I'm like, okay, time to get collect the items and go back in the cave. As I was collecting the items, randomly a shiny Dugtrio popped up.
Dude.
I was happy.
Please tell me you called your Dugtrio.
No, I became Meme Lord and named my Dugtrio the Nut Shack because I don't know what to. Because I caught a normal shiny Dugtrio and I just named it Nuts.
These nuts or just nuts?
Just nuts.
No.
I remember what the worst shiny was. Shiny Komala.
Oh, yeah. At least we have koala Pokemon.
Yeah. Do you know what shiny Komala looks like?
Though it's... No, I don't yet, but I will say that Komala's Pokedex entry is another one of the depressing ones, because it will never be awake, it will always be asleep. Oh.
I'm pretty sure Komala is just a response to the Ashes Coma theory. Now, before I send you what shiny Komala...
Ashes of Komala confirmed!
Before I send you what shiny Komala looks like, can you take a wild guess what a shiny form is?
Light blue.
Like his body will become light blue?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Top left is shiny Komala.
I'm in for a treat, aren't I?
Yes. Isn't that not the most laziest shiny Pokemon you've ever seen?
The color of the barrel changes.
It's a log. This log becomes strawberry flavored.
Well, it's at least tasty, but...
But that's it. That's all that changes. Even Comfy in the same picture I sent you, the body just becomes blue. The flowers don't change at all.
Yeah. Like, even the anchor Pokemon, which... When did you first find that thing, by the way?
Delmize?
Did you find out on the... Yeah, did you find out in the wild or in the Elite Four? Well, like most people did.
I think I heard about it because people were already battling before I went to the Elite Four. And I was kind of interested to see what it is. It's like, Delmize, the anchor Pokemon, is actually really, really good. And...
It is good. It's just that when you first see it, you're like, what the hell?
I remember I saw someone's reaction on Twitter. It's like, what is this thing, an anchor? But his forward attack, like his physical attacking animation is really cool. He just swings the anchor like from a chain. It's actually quite trippy to look at.
Indeed. Tokunamara's got another shiny.
Yeah, it's like, you just mean.
I get a little brighter.
Sunshine. A really good, I'm gonna send you more shinies, and one of my favorite shinies is shiny Rockruff and shiny Lycanroc Minde, because I could just call them Garurumon. Shiny Lycanroc Minde, wear Garurumon.
Yeah. Digimon. Which actually reminds me, you know, the other day I was able to pick up a game I didn't think I'd find on a store shelf here.
Ooh, what?
Digimon All-Star Rumble.
Oh.
Also known as Digimon Does Smash Brothers.
I played that game for a couple seconds, actually. It was interesting.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to get a review of this one out in the new year.
I just remembered I had a PS4. Maybe I'll try out Cyber Sleuths.
Well, I actually managed to pick that one up as well because it was on the Vita.
How is it? Did you play it yet?
Haven't played it yet, but that's because I got it while I was still in my Shantae hive.
Okay. You know, one of my favorites is shiny, was your name, straight up Toucan.
Oh yeah, that actually reminds me of one thing. To go back to the how does evolution work sort of thing, we get little woodpecker. I don't know what kind of bird and the midform is. And then a toucan.
It's just a straight up toucan.
How? Woodpecker? Toucan? How?
Well,
no.
Well, explain to me how Rockruff got a fursona, even though he stole a dog. I'm terrible.
Yeah, that you are. And also, Crabrawler. I hated how this thing evolved because you think that it's. Its evolution would. You'd think it would have another one to make up for the fact that it's not getting in its abominable snowman one until you get to the last area of the main story.
I remember I used Crabrawly a lot, but then I kind of dropped him even before I made him to a Crabominable.
Yeah, it's just. Guys, you.
I mean, he's useful for the...
Give him a weaker form, at least. So just... actually, there's another one. Vikavolt's one was annoying, because every time I looked up how I'm supposed to get it, it's like, it always said, Lightning Rock, Vast Pony Canyon. It's like, okay, fine, I'll look around for the special stone, because my first instinct is it's like the Moss Stone and Icy Stone to get Leafeon and Glaceon.
But no...
That was my first thought. So, like... I'm running around Vast Pony Canyon forwards and backwards trying to find this damn rock. Go into a Facebook group and say, guys, where is this damn rock? Oh, it's the canyon itself.
What? Okay.
Then why are you calling it the Lightning Rock?
That's just... Why not just level up in Vast Pony Canyon? That's all you have to say.
Yeah, like, that's so much simpler. Level up in Vastmind and Kenya. Done.
But
not level up near Lightning Rock.
But why, though? Why can he level up in Vastbone and Canyon? Why can he only level up in Vastbone and Canyon?
I can tell you why balance. It's a bug electric type with levitate and nose dig.
Okay. But what in Vastbone and Canyon makes him evolve?
The same thing they need, somewhere with like Magna Zone in that to evolve, so Vastbone and Canyon?
Oh. Oh, by the way, speaking of shiny Pokemon, you know who's the best and simultaneously the worst shiny Pokemon?
What?
Shiny Minior.
Oh, yeah.
The worst shiny, because you can easily pass him up in the wild if you're not looking for the sparkle, because
yeah.
He covers up his body. Best shiny, when he actually destroys his body, it's beautiful. I even have one and I named him Rare Candy.
Yeah, I need to find one of those for myself because I've got all the other Minior forms except the shiny form.
You know,
and I'm so glad it's just one shiny form and not a shiny form per color.
Well, technically...
Because if it was...
Well, technically it's a shiny form per color, but it is, like, the same shiny. So...
Yeah, because I was about to say, if it was one per color, I'd say, fuck that.
I mean, technically, all the colors have their own shiny, like, yellow core, shiny yellow core, but it's the same thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, sorry, it's late.
Yeah, I can tell for you. So, shall we wrap this up with final thoughts on Sun and Moon?
You don't want to get into Magearna and the unreleased special Pokemon yet?
Okay, yeah, we'll go about Magearna, but there's not much really to talk about because I haven't used her. And then, yeah, that's Marsha is unreleased, so I've been avoiding spoilers on its specifics, but yeah, sure.
I mean, I like his design, though.
Yeah, the design's cool.
You know what his typing is?
No, I don't, actually.
Okay, I believe it's Ghost Fighting.
Interesting.
This game has a lot of weird type combos.
Indeed.
I had a dream that I met like an alternate Marshadow and it was weird. Also, if...
I remember you were telling me about this.
I was like sleepy. I'm like, what did I encounter? It was a Marshadow, but it was more spiky than swirly. And to even like, if you find it in the wild, you have to answer a riddle. And after that, it goes about like a normal roaming Pokemon battle.
What are you? Why can't I understand you?
Why did it show up in my dream?
What's going on?
I'm scared.
Who am I? What is this?
Is this why Marshadow is part ghost?
Yes, it's the thing that works alongside Darkrai, and it just really screw with you.
Even though it's part fighting?
Yeah.
But Darkrai is pure dark.
Yep.
Okay. Oh yeah, one more Pokemon that's hard to, like... It's Combee 2.0, everyone, except Fire.
Ah, Salazzle. Yeah, and... Combee 2.0 has got another thing going for it.
Hear it.
Shall we talk about its Pokedex entry or just the thing itself?
Which Pokedex entry? The Sun one or the Moon one?
Whichever one refers to the reverse harem.
Alright. For some reason, only females have been found. It creates a reverse harem of a male sandalet that lives with... I can't speak. Of male sandalet that lives with. This is from Sun.
Yeah, and congratulations, Game Freak. You just told 10-year-olds that harems exist.
Well, reverse harem is like the anime one. It's like the one with the Warren High School Host Club and all that kind of stuff. But...
Yeah.
Here, what is the definition for harem according to Google? Harem? There we go, definition. I get Harambe. No.
I thought you were getting Hyrum, as in Skyrim means Legend of Zelda.
Hold on. I'm not spelling it right. There we go. A separate part of a Muslim household reserved for wives, concubines, and female servants. Except it's guys, not girls.
Yeah.
And what's weird about Salazzle is that she induces, like, pheromones, what is it? Filled with pheromones, his poisonous gas can be diluted to use in production of luscious perfumes. Okay.
Not the weirdest thing I've heard from Pokemon,
but up there.
I mean, look at her design, even. It's like...
Yeah.
I mean, I don't mind Salazzle at all. In fact, I do want a shiny Salazzle, but that's gonna be hard.
Yeah. Because, once again, you can only get it by evolving a female, and females are the rarer of the two.
Yeah, I can't wait to get a useless shiny Sandalit. This is why I don't want to go for a shiny Vepsequin.
Yeah, nor do I.
At least Salazzle looks cool.
Indeed. So,
is there anything else we can talk about?
Not particularly, honestly, because we've covered the main story, we've covered the post-game, we've covered the trials.
And the Pokemon.
And the Pokemon, and the Pokedex.
And the Z-moves. Well, Pokedex...
And the Z-crystals.
Well, the Pokedex so far, like, I really want to know what Rotom's Pokedex entry would be like.
You do know you're probably setting yourself up for disappointment.
I want him to boast about himself.
I do too.
This Rotom is a good...
Oh yeah, that actually...
What?
That actually reminds me, I saw this comic of Moon trying to feed Poplio some food, and then she goes, "Well, Grimer at least likes my food, my cooking." You've got Rotom going, "Well, Grimers will eat almost anything they eat. They eat trash," and you just have Poppy putting his fin up against its mouth going, no.
Grimer.
Let her have this.
Grimer is almost exclusively garb.
Just let her have this.
Great. You know, during the story, people are like, it's almost... feels like I'm in a dating sim, and Lily's the one I'm dating.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that actually reminds you of another thing, to go back to the story. Hal is a perfect way to summarize his role in the story. Hey, there is a point where you go to the Aether Foundation for the first time, and you've got, I think it's Wick?
Mm-hmm.
She gives Hal some more sauces. Mm-hmm. She gives you the TM Psychic.
Thank
you. Who's the trainer here?
You are, not Hal.
Yeah.
You know it's kind of messed up? And when you first meet Hal, you're like, yeah, so you're going to be my rival. And then, being me, I picked up Litten, and he picked up Rowlet. I'm like, wait, aren't you supposed to get the better one? Why are you making this much easier for me?
Yes. But at least on the plus side, when you fight Kukui in the champions room, he has the starter you didn't get, which is a nice callback to the unused Professor Oak battle.
Yeah, I love that.
So much nice little bits of attention to detail.
I know. It's
shame it couldn't go the one step further in regards to that soundtrack.
But the majority of soundtrack is cool. I love Lucemune's battle theme.
I do too, it's just that if I'm listening to a song from the soundtrack, chances are it's Vast Pony Canyon, because I love that song.
Well, if I listen to anything with the name Canyon in it, I'd go back to Mystery Dungeon.
True.
So, what's interesting about Alola is that a lot of the towns are very interesting, especially on Akala, which majority of Akala residents are immigrants from Jhoto. So, a lot of it has this Jhoto feel to it.
Yeah. Which I do really like. It's a nice bit of attention to detail. Oh, and that actually reminds me of another thing. If you go back to Ula Ula Island,
the garden where you had to... Well, the garden right near the town where you enter?
Mm-hmm.
If you go to there, there are these five trainers on the Golden Bridge. And it is a gigantic reference to Nugget Bridge.
And that's great. There's also...
To the point where all of them have the same Pokemon. They say the exact same lines until the very end where the guy goes, "No, Team Rocket's been disbanded for years. I wonder what happened to old Mr. Giovanni."
Well, it's been speculated that he died, but I doubt it.
No, he didn't die because he went to the PWT.
Oh yeah, true.
And this is Pokemon. You don't die. Unless you're an NPC, in which case you get killed off.
unless if you're doing a Nuzlocke. Well, yeah, a Nuzlocke.
Yeah, that too.
What is your favorite island, and where would you want to live on Alola?
Akala Island's my favorite. And I'd say I'd live near Lana's Trial, actually, because I like living near water.
Right.
Even though I don't personally live near water, I just like the thought of living near, like, a lake or a bit of the ocean, so...
Well, I'm surprised you didn't go to Pony Island and just lived in Seafolk Town, where the restaurant is in a whalelord boat.
Land-bound near the water, not sea-bound near the water.
True. I mean...
And at least Akala Island has stuff on it.
Yeah.
Rather than just the Seafolk Village.
Isn't Akala Island with the breeder? Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
I mean, if I were to live there, I'd probably live in Kony Kony City, which feels less than a city, because you can't... I mean, it says it's a city, but it's more of a town.
Where is it again?
It's on the far left, south left of the island. It's where Olivia lives.
Oh yeah.
That's a lot of useful shops there.
Indeed. Including a shop that people have been asking for them to bring back for years. A place where you can buy the evolution stones.
Ah, yeah. Also really useful TMs and herbs. And
it's been 3,000 years.
And you know what? You can also practically buy heart skills too.
Yeah.
Right. And you can get exclusive fossils and there's incenses, there's all kinds of fun stuff here.
I'm kind of surprised there wasn't any fossil Pokemon this time. Like new fossil Pokemon.
Oh, true. I guess they didn't find a need for new fossil Pokemon because with all, like...
There's so many dinosaurs you haven't done yet. Where's my Velociraptor Pokemon?
Oh, I want a dodo Pokemon. Not Doduo, but like an actual dodo.
Yeah. We got two T-Rexes, why can't I have my Velociraptor?
Not time yet.
Oh.
I'm sure they have...
Fine, I'll live with my Amora and Aureus.
You know, because... I'm thinking each game is going to have less and less Pokemon because there's just so many Pokemon now that it's an ever-shrinking Pokedex.
I think it's going to stay around this number for a bit.
Yeah.
Because this number and extra forms, that seems like a nice balance.
Yeah, because Gen 5, the Pokedex in Gen 5 kind of was a mistake.
I think the Pokedex of Gen 5 was so big because you could only get Unova Pokemon then.
Yeah.
So they couldn't have, like, here's, like, 60 Pokemon and we're not throwing in any extra Pokemon from the older generations. They couldn't do that.
Yeah, but I don't know why. I just feel Unova was kind of forgettable for me. But then again, I didn't play Black and White 2.
Which you really should.
I know.
At some point.
I know. I know it's really good. I just... I really wish I could just get it for a cheaper price.
Let's play Black 2, White 2.
Yeah, I want to get White 2 because White was the one I started with, and I guess White will be the one I'm ending with.
Yeah.
And I do like Reshiram. Hey, drop the thing. And I guess Chorus would make more... I guess Chorus would make more sense, even though Chorus's Pierce's makes kind of less sense in Alola.
He makes more sense in Black 2, White 2, and one person I wasn't really expecting at all, Grimsley.
He just shows up.
What are you doing here? Well, to be fair, I wasn't expecting Chorus either, but Grimsley? What are you doing outside of the Elite Four? Get back in
was
there!
Was anybody expecting Annabelle from Emerald? Because nobody was expecting anyone from Emerald.
No, but I'm glad that she's there. Because at least they finally do acknowledge we wanted the Battle Frontier.
Sorry I wasn't here in Oros. Kinda late here too. What's going on?
Good. Go get the rest of the Frontier brains and meet me here. Off you go now. Chop chop.
Well, my favorite appearance is Red and Blue. When they both said, who would you rather fight, did you say red or blue?
I said red at first, but for Moon, I'm going blue.
Yeah, when I first saw him, I'm like, who would you rather fight? Red. I still need my comeuppance after Gen 4. I mean, not technically Gen 4, but Gen 2.
Yeah. Oh, you came here to look for a new mountain? Too bad I already took it.
Red's like... No.
No. I steal all the mountains. I own everything.
I wish Red would be one of the challengers to the champion.
Hopefully, and his only line could be, I want my mountain.
Dot, 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 dot.
Yeah.
You know, it's fun, since Red and Blue came to come for Alola, there's been a lot of shifts with them.
Indeed, and I will admit another missed opportunity for it was getting the other trainers in. Especially after I showed you that bit of artwork that had all the female trainers with Alola designs. Like, I want all the players of Rivals.
I want Leaf.
I know I'm greedy, but please.
I want Leaf.
Yeah, at least Leaf.
No, Leaf never happened. I am still bummed out about Chris from Crystal.
Oh, you mean Lyra?
Not Lyra! I hate Lyra! I hate Lyra for that reason.
Who's Chris? Are you sure you don't mean Lyra?
Lyra is my least liked protagonist because what they did to Chris.
You know, I'm right here, guys.
I hate Lyra.
Who's that, Lyra?
I hate Lyra. I hate Lyra.
I'm at least glad that Mei didn't get the same treatment.
Yeah.
She got a massive redesign, but she is still Mei.
It's still Mei.
Thank you.
I mean, I guess she... I do like the bandana more than the bow, but you can still say it's Mei.
Yeah, it's hands down, it's Mei.
Yeah. Sure.
Now to see if Dawn will get the same treatment as Lyra, I mean Crystal, or if she gets the same treatment as Mei.
Oh yeah, Dawn? Oh, you mean Fawn.
I was in the anime! Oh!
Who are you?
3 seasons, I was in the anime. I even went to Unova!
Who are you again?
I won everything in the Adventures manga. I am the champion of Sinnoh. I beat all the gym leaders. I am a contest champion. I took down the Battle Frontier. By myself.
I can imagine.
I caught Reggie Gigas with that loaf. Diamond.
I can imagine if I really doubt there's going to be, well, clearly not going to be anytime soon, but it's going to be a Gen 6 remake with Purina. Marina.
No, don't you mean Sarina?
Marina will have a Sarina, and she's totally not Serena.
What would make it even more insulting is that if it is the post-haircut design.
Oh, true.
If that's the default look, and they call her Marina with a Tsarina.
I'm just gonna name her Serena.
Anyway, final thoughts overall for Sun and Moon?
Fun. It was a good game. I love the change of what they did to make it fresh.
It is a nice change of pace, especially after we've had 6 generations of Gym Leader, Gym Leader, Gym Leader, Gym Leader, Evil Team, Gym Leader, Gym Leader, Gym Leader, Elite Four, Champion, bye-bye. See you next game.
Yeah.
Off you go.
I could only imagine. They did so much with Alola, and it is the 20th anniversary game. But what are they going to do after? How are they going to top this? How are they going to breathe? How are they going to make a game after this game breathe fresh life into the Pokemon series?
As I said earlier on, I think it could work if they have a mix of the two with Gym Leaders and the Island Trials. Mm-hmm. But I still think that they need to have a way of, if you don't want to do Pokemon battles and all that, like, make contests more of a thing you can do. Like, if you wanted to, you could do the whole game without taking on a Gym Leader or the Island Trials and just do contests.
Yeah. I do miss the contest, and with like the new 3D models and everything, and if the new game isn't as, like the next gen again isn't as, is more optimized than Sun and Moon was, I could see contests doing a whole lot, especially with designs like Primarina and all that.
Yeah, like Primarina especially is dying to be in a contest.
You know what would be really good? I can imagine for the contest.
What?
What if it was just a rhythm game?
Well, that's kind of what it is.
Well,
at least it wasn't Diamond and Pearl.
Well, I mean, I guess, but like a rhythm game, like a touch rhythm game, like Elite Beat Agents or Osu or whatever it's called.
That's a game that really needs a new game. It's Elite Beat Agents.
It can be. It can be a mini game for the new Pokemon contest.
First it was Nintendogs, and now it was this. Oh yeah, actually, hey, Pokemon Refresh, that's broken.
Oh yes, it is. Just shove berries into my Pokemon and level up twice as fast.
Yeah. Also, when I was taking on Olivia as the Elite Four trainer, my Wishiwashi took like 3 direct hits and just on 1 HP and just refused to die. Thank you, Wishiwashi!
He didn't want to die for you because he loves you.
And now you always have a place on my team in Alola.
I love Wishiwashi. Wishiwashi was probably the one I used the Z-move on the most.
I think the only one who would have beat it for me was Catastropica. Just because it's Catastropica.
Bye! Throw Pikachu into the opponent.
Yeah. Later!
I don't know. I like the nuke better. When is Ash's Pikachu coming out?
Not sure. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, and the other one I do really like. Mm-hmm. And on that day, humanity received a grim reminder.
Even though then you learn that Z-move is actually kind of trash.
Well, it's good for catching Pokemon.
Yeah. I love... I love what the trainer does. It's just... give him the hammer.
So good.
You know what?
Yeah, the animations for these Z-moves go on for a while, but... damn, do they not look good.
Yeah. I mean, that's what Z-moves are. They're just really overpowered, but very flashy moves.
Yeah. And sometimes, that's all you need. Though that might be coming from... a bit biased because it's coming from someone who has put in almost 200 hours into Hyrule Warriors Legends.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, I guess we should wrap this up because we've been going for about 2 hours.
Yeah, and we've got a lot of stuff to do for the year's roundup video, which at the time this goes out will be out already, but we haven't recorded that
yet. It's just been kind of hectic because of everything that happened, happened at the end of the year right now.
Yep, but hopefully, in 2017, we'll be able to come back with a vengeance and proper.
We're getting more video content out because we do have some things we have reviews lined up for. Like, I think we still need to review Kirby Planet Robot.
Oh, yeah, we do.
And Gates to Infinity and Super Mystery Dungeon.
Well, Gates to Infinity, I'm still trying to get that game. I was having.
Just get it on the eShop.
I was having trouble with that. I don't want to spend $30 for a game I know it's at.
I had to pay $70 for it.
I don't want to buy that for a game that I know it's going to be bad.
Until you do it, we're not doing Super.
Fine. I'm going to try to get it. Anyway. enough ranting about the future. Let's actually get on to the future.
Indeed. See us all next time, which depending on when this comes out, it will either be the next one after this is gonna be the Fire Red Leaf Green Adventures arc or Shantae Hachini Hero the full review.
Right.
One of the two.
So look out for that.
It will really just depend on when I can get this edited and uploaded. So, who knows?
It's going to be a mystery until then.
A mystery dungeon?
Oh!
It all comes together.
Oh no, we're still going for that.
It's one of those easily quotable lines like, and make the bad guys cry like an anime fan on prom night.
Oh, that was so cool.
I guarantee you we're going to be talking about that thing during the year roundup.
Oh, God. Alright. I guess we're wrapping this up, but I only have one more question about Alola.
Yeah.
What was one speculation that you got horribly, horribly wrong? If you could think of any.
The trials. I was saying for a while that we were going to get one trial per type, which we didn't at the end. We got one for the 7 types plus the 4 kahunas, but we didn't get one trial per type.
Yeah, I guess it was too much.
I still want one trial per type.
Maybe.
Just saying.
I'm thinking they're probably going to do that for stars. Give trials for the Z crystals, but certain Z crystals would be optional.
Yeah, and some of the islands like Mele Island needed more stuff to it. Because there's Ilima's trial, then there's the Kahuna, then you're off to Akala.
Right. I mean, I thought Akala had kind of bad pacing compared to Mele Mele, because Mele Mele was just like, tutorial, tutorial, tutorial. Okay, you're on Akala, bye. Wait, what?
Wait, I'm not done. Okay.
It's just 4 trainers. 4 trials. 4 things. 4.
4 trainers. Not 1, not 2, not 3, not 5. 4 trainers.
No, he always, Kukui always did that.
Yeah.
I guess that was the foreshadow of the Elite Four, but still.
Yeah. What about you? What was one thing you got horribly wrong?
Oh, I don't know. What did I speculate, Abuela? Well, I speculate. Oh, here's the one thing I speculated wrong, and then I speculated right. The right thing is that I knew I got it right that there were legendary Pokemon similar to Tapu Koko for each island. That one I got spot on. What I got wrong were the island colors.
Yeah, because almost everyone was thinking it was going to be red, blue, green, yellow, but it was yellow, pink, purple, and red.
I mean, what is that? Yellow, pink, purple, and red. What is that? There's no purple Pokemon game.
I kind of want a purple game. See what they can do with it.
If there was green, if you made like yellow, blue, green, and gray, that would symbolize the special Pokemon games, but they didn't.
Indeed, but nope.
I mean, I still like what they did. And Tapu Lele is the best Tapu.
Yeah. Either Tapu Lele or Tapu Fini.
Yeah. Anyway, we should wrap this up.
Yeah, I'll let you go to sleep, and I will be... I'm actually going out to see Rogue One tonight, so that's going to be
nice.
Fun.
Oh, nice. Are you going to do a review once the DVD comes out?
Yep.
Nice.
Because, thankfully, I don't have to do another... wait for a Star Wars marathon. Well, enough content for a Star Wars marathon, because I've done most of it.
you cleaned it up.
Yeah. Unless I need to delve into Legends, in which case, fuck.
Alright, until next time.
Though, actually, no, I can ignore most of Legends, because most of it's books.
Yay, books.
Yay. Anyway, later, guys.
Alright, until next time. Alola, this time.
Alola!
It means goodbye.
Yes.